Hello friends, in last lecture we saw that how to convert decimals into p upon q form. Over there we saw how to convert terminating decimals in p upon q form as well as non-terminating but repeating decimals in p upon q form. Then we saw the irrational numbers. Over there we proved that root 2 is irrational number by long division method. Then root 3 is an irrational number by method of contradiction. Now in this lecture we'll see one more question, that how to present sum or addition of two irrational number is also an irrational number. So here is the question: show that root 2 plus root 3 is an irrational number. Okay, so let us see how to solve this. Suppose, we'll start with that only. Suppose x is equal to root 2 plus root 3. So squaring both sides gives you root 2 plus root 3 whole square. Okay, squaring both sides. Now over here I can write, okay, here again it is like this. Suppose x equal to root 2 plus root 3 is a rational number. Okay, this is again we can say method of contradiction. We are assuming that x is equal to root 2 plus root 3 is a rational number. That means whatever we have to prove, we are assuming its opposite. Okay, now here on squaring both sides, a plus b whole square, so a square plus b square plus 2 into a into b. So ultimately here I will get x square is equal to 5 plus 2 root 6. This can be written as x square minus 5 is equal to 2 root 6. See what I am doing, I am trying to make this term which is in root alone, and I am taking all other terms on the same side. So this gives me the finally x square minus 5 upon 2 equal to root 6. Now x is a rational number, we assumed. Okay, 5 is also a rational number, so x square minus 5 becomes a rational number. 2 is also a rational number, so quotient of rational number is also a rational number. It means x square minus 5 by 2 is always a rational number. But root 6 is an irrational number. A rational number cannot be equal to an irrational number. Hence, our assumption was wrong. So here, now x square comma 5 and 2 are rational numbers. Therefore, okay, as these three are rational numbers, therefore x square minus 5 by 2 is also a rational number. Therefore root 6 is a rational number. See, but obvious, as these two numbers are equal to each other, if the left hand side is rational, but obvious right side is going to be rational. Therefore root 6 is rational number. But we know that root 6 is an irrational number. Therefore, okay, as root 6, according to the this statement, root 6 becomes a rational number. But we know root 2 is, root 6 is an irrational number. So here we came to a contradiction. Therefore our assumption was wrong. But we know that root 6 is an irrational number. Thus our assumption was wrong. Therefore I can say root 2 plus root 3 is an irrational number. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now we'll see some results on real numbers. Or we can say the properties of rational number and irrational numbers. Okay, so next heading is some useful results on real numbers. Some useful results on real numbers. Okay, here we'll see some useful results on real number, that means on rational numbers and irrational numbers. So very first result is negative of an irrational number is also an irrational number. Okay, negative of an irrational number is also an irrational number. Okay, now sum of rational and irrational number, sum of a rational and irrational number is always irrational. Okay, if I add a rational number with irrational number, I'll get always an irrational number. Okay, so 2 plus root 3, pi plus 2, if I am adding one rational with one irrational, the result will always irrational. Then difference of rational and irrational number is always irrational. Okay, difference of a rational number and irrational number is always irrational. See, some difference. Now, if we talk about product. So, product of a rational number and irrational number is what? What should be the result? If I multiply a rational number with irrational number, can I say it will be always irrational? Or can I say it will be always rational? Or it might be rational, it may not be rational. See, let us see. 2 multiplied by root 3. It is definitely irrational number because root 3 is there. Okay. So 2 multiplied by root 3 is irrational. So product of a rational and irrational is irrational. Now if I take 7 multiplied by root 11, then again rational multiplied by irrational is irrational. So again I'm saying, is it possible to conclude that it is always irrational? No. Why? See, if I take 0, this is a rational number, and I multiply with this root 3, then the result will be 0, which is rational. That means product of a rational and irrational number is not always irrational. But if I add one word, this, if I say product of a non-zero rational and irrational, then definitely it will be always irrational. That means when I say non-zero rational, that means then in that case I do not have to take this example. Now if you take any rational number, even though if you take the negative rational and negative irrational, ultimately it will be rational. So product of a non-zero rational and irrational number is always irrational. Now similarly, the fifth one, quotient of, now here again I have to take care of this, quotient of non-zero, okay. Now if I take non-zero rational and an irrational number, that means 2 upon root 3, but obviously it is irrational. But if I see, quotient doesn't mean that I have to take rational in the numerator. Quotient also possible if I take this on the numerator and this on the denominator. So if I take non-zero, definitely it is always irrational. So quotient of a non-zero rational and irrational number is always irrational. Okay, so note down these 5. See, here we saw the results between a rational and irrational. Now there is one more is left, let me write that as well, then you do write. Now see, here we saw the addition of rational and irrational, subtraction or the difference of rational and irrational, then product of a rational and irrational, and the quotient of rational and irrational. Now if we take two irrational number, can we say the sum of two irrational number is always rational, or sum of difference of two irrational number is always irrational? Let us see. See, this is an irrational number. Okay. This is an irrational number and this is also an irrational number. Now if I add these two will cancel out, isn't it? And what I will get? 6, which is a rational number. So sum of two irrational number might be rational, but if I take this as plus, then this will become 6 plus 2 root 2, which is irrational. That means either we talk about sum or difference or product or quotient of two irrational number, it might be rational or might be irrational. So sixth point you have to write, the sum, difference, product and quotient, this sum, difference, the sum, difference, product and quotient, the sum, difference, product and quotient of two irrational numbers, two irrational numbers may be rational or irrational, may be rational or irrational. मे बी रैशनल और मे बी इरेशनल. ओके सो नाउ नोट डाउन दी सिक्स पॉइंट्स, देन विल आई विल गिव यू वन मोर पॉइंट एंड देन विल सी द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दीज ऑल, बट बिफोर दैट प्लीज नोट इट डाउन. ओके नाउ विल टेक वन मोर पॉइंट. ओके सेवेंथ पॉइंट, इफ ए एंड बी आर टू रैशनल नंबर्स, इफ ए एंड बी आर टू रैशनल नंबर्स एंड ए मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बी और रूट ए मल्टीप्लाइड बी इज नॉट, और सिंपली ए मल्टीप्लाइड बाय इज नॉट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर, नॉट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर एंड ए मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बी इज नॉट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर, then root AB is an irrational number lying between A and B, lying between A and B. Okay, there are two rational numbers A and B such that AB is not a perfect square. If you multiply A and B, it should not be a perfect square. Then definitely root AB will be an irrational number as well as it will lie between A and B. For example, if I say 2 and 3, A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. Both are rational numbers. Then 2 into 3 is not a perfect square. 6 is not a perfect square. Then definitely root 6 is an irrational number which lie between A and B. Okay, now suppose if I take A equal to 4, B is equal to 9. Okay, then root AB will be equal to 4 into 9, that is 30, root 36, that is 6. So it won't be an irrational number. That's why this condition is given, AB should not be a perfect square. Okay, definitely root AB will be between 4 and 9, but here we are talking about irrational numbers. So if AB becomes complete square, whole square or a perfect square, then it won't be irrational number. That's why this condition is given. Otherwise definitely root AB will lie between A and B, although that won't be an irrational number. Okay, so that was the point 7th. So note it down. Then we will see some questions based on this concept. Okay, so now we'll see some question based on this. So very first question, write two irrational numbers whose sum is irrational. Okay, we saw there was a point, fifth point, in which we wrote that sum of or the difference of or the product of or the quotient of two irrational numbers may be rational, may be irrational. So here we have to write two irrational numbers whose sum is irrational. Okay, so two irrational numbers whose sum is rational. So I can write 2 plus root 3 comma 2 minus root 3, isn't it? 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3. If you find their sum, if you find their sum, 2 plus root 3, sorry, its sum is irrational. Okay, sum is irrational, then better to write in this way, root 3 plus 2 and root 5 minus 2 or root 3 plus 2, both are okay. Even though here if I write root 3 minus 2, then it is also okay. So sum is root 3 plus 2 plus root 5 minus 2. So minus 2 plus 2 will cancel out. Ultimately we'll get root 3 plus root 5, which is irrational. We know that sum of two irrational numbers is always irrational. So root 3 is irrational, root 5 is irrational. So their sum is irrational. So this is the one example. Okay. If you want to verify in this way. Now, is it possible any other way to write or any other example? See, we also saw that irrational number is a number whose decimal expansion is non-terminating, non-repeating. So is it possible to write two irrational numbers in decimal format whose sum is also irrational? Let us see. So this was the first example. Okay. Now here 2.31 3 11 3 111 3 4 times 1 and so on, isn't it? Can we say it is an irrational number? Yes. Why? First of all, it is non-terminating. Now also it is not repeating itself. 3 1 3 11 1 3 111 3 4 times 1 and so on. So this is an irrational number. Now what I have to write? One more irrational number, such that if I add this number and the new number, the sum must be irrational. So I can write 4.02022022 4 times 2 and so on. There are 4 times 2, not 4 2s. Now you can check, if you add these two, what you will get? If you add these two, here you will get 6. Okay, there is a mistake. So if I add these two, what I will get? 3 3 3 3. So that won't be irrational number. Okay, so I have to make some changes. So here I am taking 1 instead of 0, I am taking 1. Okay, now here I will get 4 3, isn't it? 3 plus 1 4 1 2 plus 1 3, then 4 double 3 4 triple 3 4 4 times 3 and so on. So this is also an irrational number. So this is the first example. See, here it was written only two irrational number. So one I gave you in the form of this square root and another one in the form of decimal. So two irrational numbers whose sum is rational, that we wrote in the fifth point. Here we gave the example to justify that statement. That means it is possible to write two irrational numbers whose sum is rational. So please note it down. Okay, now we will see next. That is, here we took two irrational number whose sum is irrational. Now we'll say two irrational number whose sum is rational. Okay, two irrational number whose sum is rational. Again, I am telling you the same thing that in fifth point we saw that sum or difference or addition, multiplication or quotient of two irrational numbers might be rational, might be irrational, may be rational or may be irrational. Here we are here I am giving you the examples of that to justify that fact. So we have to write two irrational number whose sum is rational. So very first example, I can write root 7 plus 2 and two plus root 7 and 2 minus root 7, 2 minus root 7 or 3 minus root 7, whatever, doesn't matter. Okay, when you add these two, root 7 and root minus root 7 will cancel out, and here we'll get 2 plus 3, 5, which is a rational number. So this I can say is the one of the example. Another example, I can say root 7 and minus root 7. This is also an example. If you add these two, what you will get? By adding these two, you will get 0, which is a rational number. Okay. Now, again, I will try to write one example in the decimal form as I wrote in case of irrational number. So, 4.12, 1.22, 1.22, 1.4 times 2 and so on. Okay, this is an irrational number. Why? Because it is not repeating. Because of these dots, we can say it is not terminating and it is not repeating itself. Definitely there is a pattern, but it is not repeated. Now another example, I have to write in such a way then so that when I add them I should get a rational number. 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 4 times 1. Now you can check when you add these two, what you will get? 9.2 plus 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, and so on. You will get threes, so many threes, which is not ending. So here you can say decimal shows it is not terminating, but digits are being repeated. So this actually can be written as 9.3 bar, which is a rational number. Okay, 9.3 bar, which is a rational number. So here I can say this is an example of two irrational numbers whose sum is rational. So please note it down. Then we'll come to the next question. Okay, after this we'll see next that, see here we saw the sum of two rational numbers. Now we'll see the difference of two irrational numbers whose sum is irrational as well as rational. So I can say third question, it will be write two irrational numbers whose sum is irrational. Okay, so let us see the solution. two irrational numbers whose sum is irrational. That you have to write. Two irrational number whose sum is irrational. Not sum, now difference. Okay, whose difference is irrational. So root 3 plus 5 and root 3 plus 1. Okay, their difference is okay, now definitely their difference will be an irrational number. If you find their difference, let us see. See, here we have root 3 plus 5 minus, here I wrote minus root 3 plus 5. Now, difference, now when you open the bracket, okay, here it should be that only. Okay, if you open the bracket here, it is minus root 3 minus 5. So this will cancel out and you will get 0. Okay, so we can see this is definitely correct answer, but over there I took the same number. Definitely difference of same number is always 0 and hence it will be a rational. But if I want to make it little bit different, here I can write 2. Okay, the numbers are little bit different, not exactly different, but 5 minus 2 is 3. So in that case, here answer will be 3 again, which is a rational number. So this is the, we can say, one example. The two numbers, or I can say two distinct irrational numbers whose difference is irrational. Whose difference is irrational. Okay, here the difference will be rational, not irrational. Okay, so make this changes. Difference is rational. Okay, here difference will be rational. So now let us take the another example. Now we'll take one example in decimal form. Two irrational number whose difference will be a rational number. So I can write 9.7474744744 and so on. This is the one. Now what I need, difference is rational. So here I can write 5.41411444 times 1 and so on. Now if you find the difference, what you will get, see, 9 minus 5 is 4, 7 minus 4 is 3, 4 minus 1 is 3, here again 3, 3, 3. Okay, you will get a string of 3 after decimal, which can be written as 4.3 bar, which is a rational number. So difference is rational. So please note down these two examples, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now next question. two irrational numbers whose difference is also irrational. So first I can write root 5 or 7 root 5 2 root 5. That difference will be 5 root 5, which is an irrational number. Okay, this is the one example. Another example I can write for difference must be irrational. Root 7 plus 2, or simply I can write root 7 root 11. Their difference is again an irrational number. Okay, now let me try one more example with the term of binomial. That way root 7 plus 2 and or 2 plus root 7 2 minus root 7. Okay, their difference is again an irrational number. 2 plus root 7 and 2 minus root 7, that difference is again irrational number. If you subtract, this will cancel out and root 7 will remain. Root 7 plus root 7, 2 root 7 will be the answer. So this is one more example. Now last fourth one I'll do right in the form of decimal. Difference must be irrational. Okay, so 9.545445445444 times 4 and so on. Now 7.10100200200 2004 times 0 and so on. You can see the difference. 9 minus 7 is 2, 2.5 minus 2 is 3, 4. Again 5 minus 2 is 3, here 4, 4. So 3, 4, 3, double 4, 3, triple 4, 3, 4 times 4 and so on. So difference is irrational number. Okay, two irrational number whose difference is irrational number. So note it down. Write two irrational numbers whose product is rational. Write two irrational numbers whose product is rational. So in this very first I can write root 3 comma root 3, that means two similar number. If you multiply these two you will get 3 only. So this is the two irrational numbers whose product is rational. So these we can say are the like same terms. Now I can write this 2 root 7 and 5 root 7. So these are not the same terms, but definitely they are the like terms. Their product is a rational. 5 into 2 10 and root 7, root 7 gives you 7. So ultimately it will become 70. So two irrational numbers, two irrational numbers. Now in this case it is not possible to write the number in decimal form. That means it is not possible to write two irrational numbers in decimal form whose product will be a rational number. Okay, now here I can write root 18. Okay, this is an irrational number. See, this one and this one are almost similar type of numbers. Here I wrote 2 root 7, here root 18 is actually and here I can write root 2. So actually they look at different numbers, but actually they are again like terms, because root 18 can be written as 3 root 2 only. Okay, so actually these two are the almost similar example, but still we can write this one. So root 18 comma root 2, if you multiply this you will get root 36, which on simplification gives you 6, which is a rational number. Here again if you multiply you will get a rational number. So these are the examples of irrational numbers whose product is a rational number. Okay, we can take this example as well. Root 7 minus 3, root 7 plus 3. See, here if you multiply, we can apply the identity of a square minus b square. So 7, root 7 square is 7, 7 minus 9, minus 2, which is a rational number. I can also take this, root 11 plus root 7 and root 11 minus root 7. This is again a example of two irrational numbers whose product is going to give you a rational number. Okay, so note it down. Okay, now next we'll see two irrational numbers whose product is also irrational. So write two irrational numbers whose product is irrational, whose product is irrational. So here I can write root 2 comma root 3, their product is irrational, isn't it? Then root 2 plus 5, root 6 minus 5, that's again product is irrational. Okay, now if you want to write this root 2 plus root 3 and root 5 minus or plus root 6, this is again an example of, see these are two numbers, better to write in this way, these two numbers whose product is going to be definitely irrational. Okay, ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज राइट टू इरेशनल नंबर्स राइट टू इरेशनल नंबर्स हुज प्रोडक्ट सॉरी हुज क्वोशेंट इज रैशनल हुज क्वोशेंट इज रैशनल राइट टू इरेशनल नंबर्स हुज क्वोशेंट इज रैशनल सो लेट अस सी द वेरी इजिएस्ट एग्जाम्पल आई कैन से रूट सेवन एंड रूट सेवन इजेंट इट रूट सेवन अपॉन रूट सेवन गिवस यू वन विच इज अ रैशनल नंबर Another example, okay, if you want to see here, you can write in this way root 7 upon root 7 is equal to 1, which is rational. Okay, another example, I can write root 5 root 11, comma root 11, or let it be 2 root 11. Here they are exactly same terms. Here we can say they are like terms. So here again, if I say 5 root 11 upon 2 root 11 is equal to 5 upon 2, which is definitely rational. Okay. Then third one. I can say root 27 root 3. Okay, again these two are almost same. This is like term, these are also like terms, but they are not look alike. Okay, so root 27 upon root 3 is equal to root of 27 upon 3, which is equal to root 9, which is equal to 3, and which is a rational number. Okay, now one more example. Here I can write 6 plus 3 root 5, comma 2 plus root 5. Okay, see, 6 plus 3 root 5 upon 2 plus root 5. Now if I take common 3 from the numerator, here I will get 2 plus root 5 and denominator is also 2 plus root 5 only. So I can cancel this, so I will get 3 over here, which is a rational number. Isn't it? So this is again one example. Now last, here I will write an example in terms of decimals. In terms of decimals. So here I can write 8.42422422 and another example, another rational number is 4.21211 2111 ... So if you divide this, definitely you are going to get 2, which is a rational number. So this 5 different examples we can write of 2 irrational numbers whose quotient gives you a rational number. Okay, I'm repeating again. Here I took the exactly same numbers. Instead of root 7 and root 7, you can take root 2, root 2, root 3, root 3, and so on. The only thing, both must be irrational such that their quotient is a rational number. Here 5 root 11, 2 root 11. So root 11, root 11, I can cancel. So ultimately I will get 5 by 2, which is again a rational number. Over here root 27 and root 3. See, root 27 is actually I can write 3 root 3. Okay, but as I told you, these two examples are almost similar, but over here they look alike, and they here over here they do not look alike. although they are look alike. Okay, so here by cancelling this, I will get 3, which is a rational number. This 6 plus 3 root 5, 2 plus root 5. From the numerator, I took 3 common. Okay, so you can check over 3 into 2, 6, 3 into root 5, 3 root 5. And denominator, I have already 2 plus root 5. By cancelling them, I got 3, which is a rational number. Here, instead of 2 root 5, I can write 14 plus 7 root 5. So from here I can take 7 common. From the numerator I can take 3 common. Again this will cancel out each other, and here I will get 3 by 7, which again becomes a rational number. Okay, then here finally I took the example in form of decimal 8.424224222, which is irrational number. These dots shows this is non-terminating. This shows it is not repeating itself, so it's an irrational number. Similarly, 4.21, 211, 211, and so on. By dividing this, definitely we are going to get 2. You can see if you multiply this, the denominator by 2, 4 into 2, so it will become 8. Here it will become 4, then 2, 4, then 2. So simply we can say by cancelling them, we'll get 2, which is a rational number. So note down these examples, and then we'll see one more question that in which we have to write two irrational numbers whose quotient is also irrational. But first of all, note it down. Okay, now next question, write two irrational number whose quotient is irrational. Quotient must be irrational. In such a way, we have to write two irrational numbers. So let us see if I write root 3 and root 2. Okay, root 3 and root 2, so root 3 upon root 2, that is root 3 by 2, which is irrational. Okay, so two irrational number whose quotient is irrational. Next we can write root 5 plus 2, root 5 minus 2. It is again an irrational number. Okay, these two are the examples of irrational number whose quotient is irrational. Okay, so please note it down. Okay, so that is all about this lecture. Now we'll meet in next lecture. Till then, bye. Thank you.